Columbia is very fortunate in that we recruit some of the most talented and gifted faculty. As an institution, we have a responsibility to make their lives as successful and productive and satisfying as possible.
It's important that we understand everybody's life experience so we can be better educators, so we can be better clinicians, so we can train people more effectively, and we can be better scientists.
Having a diverse faculty is very important for the care of patients, for mentorship of students and residents.
Diversity in teams improves problem solving and improves outcomes of those teams' work.
The goal of this committee is not only just having a diverse faculty, but also retaining and maintaining a diverse faculty.
How do we bring in the best medical students that come from diverse backgrounds and keep them here to be the best residents and fellows, and to keep them even longer to become the best faculty here that help not only diversify but strengthen this rich environment?
I think we're really working towards creating an environment that is more inclusive, more transparent, basically an even better place to be.
One key outcome of this committee was the creation of an office for women and diverse faculty.
The charge of that office is to act as a voice for all of the diverse women faculty here on campus.
I've done many of the programs, and I really encourage other faculty who think they would benefit, please sign up.
Anything that promotes people sharing and people talking to each other will create a better work environment.
In your own sphere of influence, how diverse and inclusive of an environment are you creating?
We as faculty, we should talk to our colleagues and invite them to join us. This is a shared accountability.
It starts with each of us.